What movie?
Her movie, I don't know, Undefeatable or something, so.
Hey, this is not a spring chicken. We decided to give you a different view today, but the big news today, of course, is President Obama is in Iowa, and it is not a campaign stop, even though other people that are running for office happen to be in Iowa, including, well, actually, Sarah Palin's not running for office either, but her, well, her movie opens, she's on a book tour, so, I mean, she has reason to be there, but, you know, President Obama, remember, it is not a campaign tour. He's there on official business, and, oh, yes, they're going to be taxing the Internet. So, for now, we're going to bring old Cam on with comments on the headlines of today.
There we go.
I know. How can you tell it's live? The sun keeps changing as we're standing here.
It started out. Actually, what happened was all of the police officers at the beach have caused the sun to go hide behind clouds.
I know. And Obama to let people know that President Bush and the Republicans are what is keeping the economy from getting better.
I know. That's the. He said that in their speech today, that we're trying to dig ourselves out from the problem that George Bush and the Republicans have caused. And it's going to take longer than we thought because George Bush and the Republicans made a worse mess of it than they really understood. He was president of the United States, folks. He was given all that information.
And wildfire shuts Los Alamos nuclear lab and forces evacuations.
Yeah, I love that. Basically, they've never cleared the ground near the lab. I mean, what type of moron would let a fire hazard happen all the way to a nuclear research facility?
And wildfire shuts. Oh, that's true.
Yeah.
Obama says Republicans need to compromise with the Democrats to save the country from defaulting because of Bush and the Republicans.
I know. No, it was Obama. Bush left Obama with a $450 billion deficit. Obama added $5 trillion to it, and he wants to add more. I mean, this is a good one. He wants to increase taxes in order to increase jobs, because you'll be able, that when, if the people are paying their fair share of taxes, meaning, okay, they have limited. If you're not making $250,000 a year or more, you won't have increased taxes, other than the fact that you're going to have new business taxes, you're going to have your home loan taken away from you, you're going to have your business expense deduction taken away from you, and he's going to he wants to charge another 50 cents a gallon on gasoline taxes for all businesses doing business using non-electric vehicles.
Oh.
Yep.
Yeah, and UK teenager charged with hacking attacks, police.
Yeah, well, at least, I knew teenagers that basically once hacked the phone company and got in trouble for it. So, the teenagers are very good at that sort of thing.
Well, they have a little bit of extra time, you know?
Yeah.
And judge blocks parts of tough Georgia immigration law.
Well, yeah, it's the part that says, and you can ask them, are you here legally? Which is not against the law, because I love this. They said if you can open up a guy's trunk without a warrant, if you can go into a home without a warrant, if you can put people in jail for 6 months or longer without any notification of any crime that they have committed, but you can't ask a person if he's here legally?
Something doesn't sound right.
I know, but that's the whole trick, isn't that something?
And court orders arrest of Gaddafi, son, and key aide.
Yeah, they said, well, that just absolutely means he's got to surrender now. I mean, he has all the incentive in the world to surrender, knowing that they're going to try him and find him guilty. You know, they want to arrest me. All these leaders that are basically leaving office, they're all going to be put on trial and executed. So why would you want to be executed?
And Gingrich defends campaign strategy, criticizes gay marriage.
Okay, first of all, it was a stupid thing for Democrats to do. I mean, do you want to hear something even more stupid? The Obama administration convinced Lady Gaga she should go to Rome, lead a gay pride event in the face of the Catholic Church, who's condemned what was done in the United States and doesn't believe in gay rights and gay marriage. But he convinced Lady Gaga it was a thing to do.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Hillary Clinton interceded in the White House, for the White House, to get her to go over there to lead the gay pride event.
Is she really going to do that?
Yeah, she's already done it. They said it was it's a political disaster. He can't, basically, he's infuriated the Catholics, infuriated the Jews, infuriated the Muslims. the independence dislike. I mean,
he's doing a good job of unifying everybody against
them. They're trying to figure out how this man possibly thinks he can get elected.
Well, I'm surprised he's still in office.
I know.
Because he's pissed off so many people. But, you know, you never know.
Well, the trick is, the reason why he's still in office
is that... Oh, he's got his insurance policy called...
Called Biden, who they think is on the verge of senility or Alzheimer's disease. If Biden goes because of health issues, it makes Boehner the president of the United States. The Democrats,
Boehner.
But they're not about to allow Obama to be tossed out, no matter how much they dislike this man.
Yeah, because they don't want Boehner.
But expect a challenge to Obama from the left. It's going to happen because they do not like him.
An immigration memo called Backdoor Amnesty by ICE Union.
Well, yeah. The basically, what it means is basically get rid of everybody that's been arrested. You know, because don't you know, just toss them out, don't keep track of what happened to them, and don't arrest them again. Yeah, which basically means they're here to stay.
Mm-hmm. Forget what you saw.
Forget what you saw, yeah.
Put a cork in the internet bubble talk for now.
Okay, don't put a cork in it because the state of California just passed a piece of legislation that basically should have been vetoed, but it turns out that all the tax increases in California were separated from the legislation cutting expenditures. So in California, it makes it, you have to pay an internet fee for any business that has a brick and mortar thing in California, which means 10,000 businesses will be shut down for Amazon, probably that many with eBay, and every small internet company in the state will be shut down. But don't worry, California's done it because they have guaranteed this will result in more jobs.
I know. TSA defends search of elderly woman in Florida.
Well, they're not denying that it happened now. They're saying that they operate within the rules. And basically, they've just pissed off way too many people. We've got little two-month-old kids, 95-year-old grandmothers that are physically disabled. On top of that, she just came from a blood transfusion and was very sick, you know, getting ready to go undergo chemotherapy, and they basically, I heard one guy say this morning, if she dies as a result of what's going to happen, they're going to hold Janet Napolitano guilty of an accessory for murder, because that's what it was.
Oh, really?
Well, yeah, because they put the woman under massive stress. Yeah, and it shouldn't happen. And they said what it is they've got a whole bunch of bullies working with TSA. It's a good one. How can you tell if it's a Democrat talking about the TSA or Republican?
Oh, just listen to what they're saying.
Yeah, they basically say George Bush is responsible for all of this. That we've got 10 years of paranoia because of George Bush and the Republicans. And that this is the result of what George Bush and the Republicans did. These people are only doing their jobs, but because of what George Bush and the Republicans caused, this is the result.
Mm-hmm.
And they said, just look at it this way. Just think how much worse things would be if we didn't have Obama running the TSA.
Yeah.
That's a very stupid thing to end with, folks.
Bulls ready to charge into Walla Worry.
Oh, it's a bear market, folks, because, I mean, there's riots. I love this. Even though there's riots in the street, Greece is a socialist country that, don't worry, they're going to pass the austerity measures, which they didn't do the first time around it was supposed to be done on them. And our market is just roaring. Of course, you have to understand, the market is all going up on things that Obama has control over. The market is down on things that he doesn't have control over.
And Americans worried by soaring college tuition fees.
Yeah, because they can't afford to send people to college, which is what it should be. I mean, I remember when I went to college, it was supposed to be a big deal. My father went to college, it was supposed to be a big deal. And then other members of my family went to college, and basically anybody could go to college. All you had to do was to be a minority member, and it was an automatic entrance. So.
And Tobey Maguire sued over poker winnings.
I know, this is ridiculous. I mean, a guy raised money to play professional poker. He lost in the matches, so they're suing everybody that won in the poker matches against the guy that raised, you know.
Wait, they're suing the people that won against him?
Yeah, they want the money all returned that they won. You know, that's called, you know...
it's poker!
It's poker, you know, but that's how they do things in this country now. They want all their money back. If they lose it, they don't feel... It's the same thing as the housing industry. why should all of these people that bought their houses actually have to pay for them? You know, they worked hard, they lost the houses, now the government should give it to them to live in, so.
And Los Angeles Dodgers filed for bankruptcy and blamed the MLB.
And basically, I think the Major League Baseball is in the process of seizing the team today, you know, and they're going to sell the team and for the to someone that they can trust, which means somebody that will play ball on their terms, not.
Well,
see,
you know, that's what happens when they got divorced. Blame it on the Dodgers' wife.
Well, yeah, she thought that she was going to get the team, which was the judge would give her the team. No, judge didn't give her the team. But the problem comes is they said that, okay, the Major League, they'll lose in court because Major League Baseball has stopped a $150 million loan he was getting. Major League Baseball, they allowed the Mets to sell part of their team, but not McCourt because they don't like him. He's not one of them, you know. He's basically earned his, he made his living the hard way. He didn't inherit it, so.
Animonzi Bubbleism from the Mark Twain of the Animal Kingdom.
Oh, you know, this one I've changed it a little bit, but actually we'll do it today. Since you can't please can't please everyone anymore, be prepared to be sued by those that you can't please.